In response to this comment, we are creating this tutorial to show how to do this. When you drag the slider, it will draw different patterns for you. Okay. So first, let's look at how to draw a triangle. Then we'll slowly move on to draw different polygons and then move on to the pattern. Okay. So if I want to draw a triangle, I'll go to events. When green flag clicked, okay, I will move first. Then I will turn, draw a triangle. I need to turn 120 degrees. After that, I'll need to repeat this 3 times. So I'll go to Control, repeat 3 times, do this. But if I run the code like this, it will make the cat move. So if I want to draw, I need to use this extension called pen. Mine is already here. If you don't see the pen here, you will click this purple color and select pen. Okay. So I'll go back. I'll use the pen. When green flag clicked, I want to erase everything. I want to draw from a blank page. After finish drawing, I want to lift up the pen. So let's do this. We have a triangle. Now, what if I don't want a triangle? I want a square, or I want a hexagon, I want an octagon. Okay, so we will drag this out. I want to make this a separate block. So go to my blocks, make a block called draw pattern. Okay, so we have this draw pattern. And when green flag clicked, we just need to draw pattern. Okay, make the cat invisible. Draw the pattern. Okay, so if I want to draw a square, I will change here 4 times. And every time turn 90 degrees. If I want to draw a polygon with 5 sides, it will be 5. I'll turn 72 degrees like this. Okay. Now, I don't want to change the number here. I want to use a slider. So I'll go to variables. I'll make a variable, number of sides. So I have number of sides here. The other thing I want to be able to control is the length of each side. So I'll make another variable. I call side length. So I have 2 variables. And all these are 0. I want to change this to a slider. Change this to a slider as well. Okay, the side length, I don't want it to be too big or too small. So I'll right click, change slide range. I'll make it maybe 25 to 45. You can experiment with different ranges. Okay, number of sides, minimum is 3 sides, triangle. Maximum, I want to go to 15, because if you go higher, it will become more like a circle. So I'll make it 15. Okay. Now, instead of repeat 5 times, I'll need to repeat number of sides times. Instead of turning 72 degrees, I'll need to use a mathematics formula. So it will be turning 360 divided by number of sides. And instead of moving 100 steps, I will move side length steps. Okay, so let's say I want side length to be 30. Number of sides to be 6. We have this, right? If I choose number of sides to 9, length to 36, I will have this. Okay, so what we are doing now is every time we need to click a green flag to have one pattern. What if I want to continuous drawing? Every time the user drag the slider, I will draw a different pattern. So I'll need to add a loop. Go to Control, loop forever. Right, so click. Now you only need to click green flag once. It will change. But then it keeps on drawing. It's a bit distracting. So what can we do? Go to my blocks, right click, draw pattern, edit. Wrong result, screen refresh. Okay. Okay, now let's try again. Okay. So it will just change. Okay. Next thing, I want to have different colors. So I'll go to a pen. Okay, I'll start with some color, but every time I draw, I want to change pen color. Okay, and after I finish drawing, I want to wait for a while rather than it keeps on refreshing. So I will go to control. I'll wait for 1 second. Okay, let's try. Okay. You can see it's changing color as well. Okay, so now we only have one polygon. What if I want a pattern? I want many polygons to draw together. I will introduce another variable called number of shapes. Okay. I'll change this to slider as well. Let's think about the range. Range minimum, I can have 1. Maybe maximum, I'll change to 20. Okay, so instead of draw one polygon, I will draw, let's say if I drag this to 5, I'll draw 5 polygons, then they kind of form a circle. So I'll need another loop. So repeat, how many times? I need to repeat, depends on how many shapes I want to draw. So I need to draw this, number of shapes. And remember, this is our code to draw one polygon. So I'll drag this inside the loop. That if I just do this, I'll draw one polygon, I'll stay at the same place, draw another polygon. So after I finish drawing, I need to turn. Turn. So after I finish drawing one polygon, I need to turn how many degrees? This will be another maths formula. So it'll be 360 divided by number of shapes. So when you draw the total number of shapes, it will form 360 degrees. It will form a circle. So let's put it here. Put back this. Okay, now stop. Let's run again. You can see it's already here. Okay, so if you drag, it will change. But this location is not very good. It will overlap with the sliders. So before we start, we will start from a specific location. I want it to move the right a bit and move down a bit. Okay, and I also want to start always at one direction. Okay, now let's stop. Start again. Okay, so you can drag any of the slides. You will have a different pattern with a different color. Subscribe to our channel to watch more fun videos.